The second session of play, day two here at these WTT Finals Men 2023 here in Doha. All Chinese affair, Chinese interests across all the four remaining quarterfinals here in this session of play, singles and doubles to come later. This Ma Long not involved in that event. Lin Gaoyuan will be back in action doing double duty. With a few of the players involved. Off to a good start here, a couple of points.
Ooh, it's a fortune off the flick. Coiled wrist of the golden hand there coming into play. And then to the forehand into the middle. Sometimes I think the power of Lin Gaoyuan can be underestimated because of how spinny he is. Doesn't seem to come through as quickly. Is it coming down? It is!
Yeah, no messing there. No mistake.
Similar kind of situation when we saw Fan Zhendong miss that absolute sitter against Ugo.
Yes.
Do you remember that?
Yeah, absolutely.
Ljubljana, star contender. This is an excellent start so far. Ma Long just looks a little bit ginger in the blocking game. But he's constantly varying the placement here, the Dark Knight. One of the key ingredients to slay the dragon.
He hasn't really started yet, Ma Long here. It took quite a while when he came out onto the Infinity Arena. Of course, that's fine. Settling in, but he hasn't really settled in, hasn't been allowed to settle in as well into this match yet. Long way to go, but his supporters are not used to this, losing five of the first 6 points to Lin.
What?
To work very hard to get just a second point there.
See the evolution of the sport here, epitomising this rally. The game has become closer to the table naturally, especially noticeable in the men's game, where we've seen more loop-to-loop rallies on average than the women's game. And the rallies, and the shots specifically, are shorter and sharper. You get the power and the spin through acceleration, and you have to be able to recover for the next ball. That's the key. Reasons, really, why game has become what it is today.
Oh, brilliant again. This is a fabulous opening from the Dark Knight. Really is.
This might be the best opening game I've seen him play all season here. Big confidence booster. I mean, we know he's got that best ever win percentage for a season.
He's about 10% above his career average win percentage. It's a good point you make, Fraser. But it's been such a big season for him. You know, you talk about that European summer series, lost to Ma Long there, and then in the Champions, such a wounding loss to Tomokazu Harimoto. But what he's done, Fraser, I mean, there's evidence of it again. We know about the ability, but the titles he's won, the couple of titles he's won, it's been like a reset this season for him. Getting over the line in those finals seems to absolutely have inspired him to a different level.
I think part of that is just maturity and getting a little bit older. I mean, he is the second most senior player now in the China Big Five after Ma Long. But yeah, massive confidence booster for him beating Zhang Wujin in the final of that star contender Bangkok.
That was huge for him. I mean, the reaction said it all. And then, of course, beating Fan Zhendong to win the Zagreb title as well.
Yeah.
And this, I mean, Ma Long here is not used to this sort of treatment. 7 game points? Are you kidding? Look to inch his way back, of course, here. Best of five.
I'll try everything here, Ma Long.
I mean, that is one of the best.
go, yeah, and he's one of the spinniest players in the world. So maybe Ma Long there just going a little bit further back. Help him calibrate his counter.
Very purposeful off the receive there.
Not long.
He has to keep thinking. One shot ahead here. You can see push long, got the bat high, ready to counter the inevitable almost Lin Gaoyuan spin off that kind of ball.
Ball it. Rip that. Just ever so slightly, long, trying to tease him. And he took it on and delivered.
Spectacular backhand. You don't see many light Lin Gaoyuan in that sense. Comes in full circle, doesn't it? Better here. You can see there, just a little bit of craft in the serve. Slightly wrong foot to Lin, and then it's curtains.
Dangerous there, trying to push longer again, and don't get that quite right. He's been burned again.
The touch has been absolutely impeccable. Not easy to handcuff Ma Long.
Yeah, master trapping spin in the short game, but Lin more than equal to him so far. Well, just if you say that, maybe. The first time, he's got a little bit stuck with his push, Lin, that time.
Courtesy of the length of this.
Yeah.
Half long, and it got a bit of indecision, and then comes in, transfers his weight from his right through to his left with a bit of a fade there. Beautiful.
That's glorious.
Delicious, dainty drop there.
Well, they call him the golden hand. Banked big time there.
Reminded me of the Fan Zhendong push that we saw earlier. We are seeing a little bit loose play, a little bit of some loose play here.
Well, he set that serve, he doesn't get that right. Just a little bit, maybe it's a comparative. I mean, dip is too strong a term, but it's bar he set opening game. Back at it there.
We knew that set one was going to be tough to replicate. As Ma Long will look to tighten the screw, and we'll think of solutions. See how Lin Gaoyuan tries to reinvent himself, perhaps, on the receive here. Nice change of service from Ma Long. Doing like the reverse pendulum serve. Serve that he doesn't do as much, but the way that he shielded there, but still managed to transfer a bit of energy forward, not relying on the rubber to do everything, really helped apply pressure on Lin Gaoyuan from a defensive position. Shovel serve again.
Yeah, variations paying off, 6 of the last 8 points. I mean, it kind of so quickly this has happened, but it's happened all the same. Ma Long here with 5 game points to level up. Only needs the one. Well, I I mean, the head-to-head might be 7-0 tomorrow long, but the last three meetings in that rivalry, there have been no drubbings, no blowouts, if you like. And this won't be one here, but it's an intriguing period of the quarterfinal now, the amazing start that Lin Gaoyuan made, and now the customary recovery from Ma Long. Who will seize the initiative next here?
Shovel serve again.
It's these service variations you picked out in game two, Fraser, troubling Lin Gaoyuan, because of course always generally goes with the pendulum, as you say, looking to set the forehand up as well, Ma Long, but that's how he's got back into this, and at least in part, yeah, been the service variation.
It has. It means Lin Gaoyuan has to go against the side spin a little bit more. A bit more difficult for him to do that as a lefty with the backhand flick from the forehand side, and that's why Ma Long is putting it into that area. Amazes me how Ma Long is able here still to transfer weight when he hasn't fully planted the feet. That was a lovely flick there from Lin.
Coming round it so nicely. Nothing to separate them here. It's this first towel break of game three. Just so smooth, Lin Gaoyuan, to watch around the table. Same time as we see, so particularly in that opening game, he possesses real power as well. Reactions and just the way he glides around on the surface is so good to watch.
And this is why we've been calling him Cat-like, because he always seems to land on his feet.
Yeah.
And just purring, isn't he? And the way that he plays, like you say, glides and moves so well.
Oh. And then he pounces there, flicks that away. I really do liken him. I think of him as the table tennis equivalent of a cat, because cats are incredibly intelligent creatures, very stealthy in their attacks, very intelligent.
And it fits the branding of being the Dark Knight, and it's different to what a puppy would feel. Unconditionally loving and almost foolish. In a good way, don't get me wrong, but...
Well, that's what always owners of cats say, is that you can't control. Compared to a dog, for example, you can't control a cat. Ask them to go anywhere. They'll do it if they want to.
Yeah.
Got it!
And Lin here in this third game so far is largely doing what he wants to. 6 of 9. That's the last 3 points, more pertinently. Oh, my.
Ma Long, are you serious? A wide touch with the backhand.
Here we go. Into the corner and
a
bang.
Cavalier leaning cross the body winner down the line. Oh, that is my favourite shot of the day.
I can understand why.
It's audacious to even try.
It's helping him here back into this game. Now, made that a number of times, but this one, quite the execution he needed, and that's 3 points in a row into the tail break for Ma Long. This just goes back and forth, much like their recent meetings. Just little shifts, ebbs and flows to the matchup.
And I can't help think, I mean, Lin Gaoyuan, we know he's had some dark moments where he struggled to finish the match as it is. But that's what makes Ma Long seem superhuman, how he's just found the wiggle room there, created some magic. A highlight reel point when he's trailing levels. And that has to be scarring and living the memory of Lin Gaoyuan.
Been a game of runs so far, mini runs, it's a decisive run being put together by Lynn.
He's pressed the reset button hard here, hasn't he?
Yeah, a couple of points since the towel break. He's very much won them. That's the good thing about this at the moment. The points are being won.
Yeah. That's a good point you made there, Guy, because sometimes you feel like it's more of a player not playing well than the other player really winning the points, but this is the true definition of a match.
Again.
I mean, that is almost a perfectly played flick there from Lynn. Maybe the only thing wrong with it was that Marlon knew where it was going to go. Maybe he needs to add a bit of more creativity into the attacks that he plays. Because Marlon, from 6-3, has almost perfectly gauged the percentage of how he needs to play each point, based on the body language of Lin Gaoyuan, and Ma Long knows and understands the mentality of Lin.
Now, this is where that head-to-head comes into play in these tight moments.
Got it!
He was alive to that little variation. Chop there from Ma Long here.
Yeah.
Right to it.
Tried that little faint push, but was in an uncomfortable position for him to, like, get his wrist in that position to play into the forehand of Lin, and that's why it popped up so much. And Lin, to be fair to him, didn't think about it too hard. Just got it done. When it sits up like that, sometimes you can easily overthink it, especially in moments like this.
Pushed into a defensive position there, don't say that too often.
Bided his time there really well, Lin, because Ma Long doesn't often lob, he fishes, so you don't have as much time as what you would have if he went back and lobbed. That can be intimidating, but Lin wasn't intimidated.
Game point.
Got it!
Got it! Back in front here.
Tell your friends to tune in right now. This is the thing. You're not really going to see Ma Long at his very, very, very best unless he's tested to that extent.
There we go, hopping up in that iconic motion along that forehand.
And Gaoyuan has to keep taking calculated risks here. Can't just sit there on the backhand side. Bit too comfortable, that one, for Ma Long. He anticipated it basically as soon as, if not before, Lin Gaoyuan even contacted the ball. Better there. More aggressive. More oomph in the backhand rip of Lin.
As we said, he can really clatter it as well, Lin Gaoyuan, and he doesn't look like it compared to the others. Making that point, weren't we, in his round of 16 encounter here with Anton Schalberry. Marlon takes time away from him there. You often make the point about Ma Long, about his backhand side, that he uses it to set up beforehand. But I mean, we see there, really aggressive weight transfers going on to win that point. Capable, of course, of doing it, even if the forehand has always been the main earner.
Oh, it's an incredible backhand, but it's more springy than hard. And it's that springiness that gets the spin. which then gets the passive ball, which the forehand comes in on.
Yeah, and feasts on.
That's the idea behind Ma Long's style, what he's incorporated.
Good counter from Lin there. Sit down to two again, the deficit.
Right into that right pocket, Ma Long there. Couldn't quite get there and make enough space to play the shot onto the table. Dwell on that. You can hear with the sound, the contact, quieter. Contacted it finer. Basically uncounterable.
Yeah, here, Ma Long's many supporters, of course, courtside, very pleased with this recent passage of play. I'll be pleased with that as well. He's just rolling through the gears here. As he looks to force a fifth.
I think he will.
Seen this movie a few times.
Unlike other sequels, it seems always as good as the first time you watched the first moment, the first scene. You could argue it gets better and better. Thanks to the directors at CTTA. The fire pit, the constant conveyor belt of class. It is impossible to ignore.
Ooh. Yeah. There's an edge there. Time it's a suck, yeah. Both. That's intriguing. Yeah, that one right in the corner this time.
To beat the dragon.
But that timeout, you talk about it being mental, psychological, gave Lin Gaoyuan a chance as well. Just a minute, 50 seconds, a minute from Ma Long there, just for Lin to think about it.
Yeah.
About the score line. Despite losing that, of course, Ma Long now with two serves to come here will look to force the decider. Despite losing that point. Game points to take this quarterfinal all the way.
Got it!
Pushed out there to the end. I mean, what an angle Lin has found there. You see where Ma Long ends up on the flooring in the court here at the end of this another really watchable rally.
That was emphatic, wasn't it? Oh. And then this one, the final blow. Beautiful. What a bit of construction there. Didn't go too hard, didn't get impatient, didn't get daunted. Patient yet positive, that was the key.
Two gone, one to go here for Ma Long. mind goes back, of course, to that meeting in Budapest where Lin was ahead in the fourth and ended up losing in five.
Johnny!
And they'll go five again here. He's won them all, but they've rarely been straightforward, especially in recent times. Just looking at the two of the most recent three meetings, we talked a lot about the European Summer Series, the star contender in Budapest, 11-9 in the decider, but also international level. Most recent meeting prior to here in Doha, the Asian champs quarterfinal. That's Ma Long's one singles title of the 2023 season. He won 13-11 in the decider there in the fifth. And look at this, how tight it is right now. The longer look, if you like. The last 32 points, 16 apiece. This is on a knife edge. Oh, and that just scuttles through. Maybe got a little bit of tape. Bit of net there. Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, he'll take that. When you think about that head-to-head, he'll take this start. First 3 points in the bank.
What a moment here.
Boy.
Wow.
Remember, Ma Long's used his timeout as well here.
It's a good point you made that. I mean, Lin has had a great season. He's had virtually no losses that you could class as a bad loss. But this might be the game to help send him into the next phase of his career.
Now, looking at that head-to-head one more time, it'd be foolish to look too far ahead, especially with who's against him here. What's gone on before? Still is an excellent platform. He goes to his timeout now.
This could be where the floodgates open for Lin if he can get it done. What he needs is faith, but the kind of faith where you aren't just relying on it to happen for you, but you have the faith that if you give it your all, it will come true.
Well, if you like, existentially, he needs to take the leap of faith himself. What you're getting at here. Still, surely it'll feel so far away at this point, though. All that's gone before.
And if Ma Long's in the kind of mindset where he can consciously think about that and act upon that, hit those spots, those areas of insecurity, he might well beat Lin in this game.
Got it! That's a shot that has paid off several times in this matchup. He really has ripped that again. And there was real belief in that. And they turn around, of course, the deciding game with Lin having finally got there to five. The switch ends. Ma Long trailing by two again. Lin here with the service as well. I think answering your question as well, whether he takes or not, you look at the platform here. The fact it's not a final, I know he's won finals this season, it's not a final here to try and get this first win.
Oh!
To win it a couple of times over there.
He did. And Ma Long is a final boss that he's happening to meet here in the quarters. Look at this. Absolutely blows it. I mean, it's a miracle Ma Long got the first one back. Full extension, that bunny hop backhand in full flow. It is absolutely beautiful. No matter where you watch it from. Apologise there, Lin. Maybe it hit the top edge slightly, I'm not too sure, but it flew. Absolutely flew.
Got it!
Ooh.
this would be heroic, given what he suffered in his career as well.
Yeah, I mean, again, you talk about the importance of winning that event in Bangkok as well, and following it up, the win over Fahn in Zagreb, but it was just given him, it seems, such confidence. Renewed confidence. Take his career to the next level then. Oh, no! Another edge, yeah, Marlon can't believe that. Remember, there's a couple of edges previously in succession. Previous game, and another one here. This is one that's being played at the margins, of course.
Oh, Marlon.
He wonders whether it's not going to be his day here. Moments like that. Lin now 3 points away.
Brilliant. Absolutely spellbounding here from the Dark Knight. Into the middle, and then that angle. Pinpoint precision, sky-high level. And he's reaching new heights here, two away from slaying the dragon.
Got it!
Yeah, he's the stronger here. This is incredible. The greatest of all time, seemingly on this day, on this occasion here, has no answer to this. 6 match points for Lin.
No way did he just do that serve. That is the serve that he pulled out against Zhang Jika years ago. I think it was at the Kuwait Open. The Kuwait Open.
What does he do here? He's still in deep trouble. He has done it. The Dark Knight, Lin Gaoyuan, brings new...